Hello friends, now we are going to perform an experiment to determine the height of a building using a sextant. So first of all, what is a sextant? So this is the machine. Majorly, it can be said that this machine has two parts. One is carrying the scale and another is movable, and these two red parts are two mirrors through which we can observe the height of a building. You are going to know about this in a while. This sextant rests on a stand like this, and let us consider we have a building in front of us and we want to calculate its height. In fact, in front of this building, this sextant is very small, but just for representation purpose, we are enlarging it so that we get a better perspective and better understanding. Now, if we look through this telescope towards this building, we will find that a light reflected from the building comes to the mirror, and after some arrangement, it comes to our eye. This is a special kind of mirror, or say glass, because half of its part is glass and half of its part is mirror. So let us consider you have a line or a mark on the building. So in that case, because one part is a glass and one part is a mirror, left side view you will see directly from the building, and the right side view was reflected from the mirror arrangements and then reached to you. Now you can rotate the moving part and see the highest part of the building. So the mark in the glass is intact, which is representing your horizontal line. Now you can see the highest part of the building, and you can also measure that at what angle you were earlierly present and at what angle you are now. You can measure its reading just like you measure a reading on a screw gauge. To know more about how to take a reading on a screw gauge, you can watch my video shown on the eye mark. We can construct a right angle triangle here like this. Just because this sextant is very small and it is at a large distance from the building, and the distance between these two lights is very small, then there is a very less scope of error because of this difference, and the another end is almost at 90 degrees. Now if we calculate the distance between the building and the sextant, we can calculate its height. Unfortunately, we have some hurdle in between, so we can use a trick to calculate this. Let us consider this is at position A, then we can shift to at position B and we can measure a new angle alpha 2. Similarly, shift this to position C, where you can measure the third angle alpha 3, and finally just make a table of it. So overall, at three positions A, B and C, we observed the initial angle, we also observed the final angle, and their differences are alpha 1, alpha 2 and alpha 3. And finally, we calculate this value cot alpha. Now use this formula. The height of the building is h plus distance between A, B, cot alpha 2 minus cot alpha 1. Just because this small h is the height of the sextant and the rest part is the height of the building, in addition to that, overall we can make three combinations of this. First, using AB distance and alpha 2 and alpha 1 as angles. In the second case, BC the distance, and alpha 3 and alpha 2 are their respective angles. And in third case, we can use the distance between AC points, and alpha 3 and alpha 1 are their respective angles. So in this way, we are going to calculate three heights, and finally, for getting an accurate value, we can take a mean of them. So isn't it very simple experiment? Just let me add something to your knowledge. Why this is known as a sextant? Because its scale covers 1/6 part of the whole circle, which is 60 degrees. So that's why it was named sextant at the very first place. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Take care and have a very good day. Bye bye.